The following program is designed to demonstrate simple workouts that you can use to improve your health. Be sure to consult your physician before beginning any exercise program.
Stay tuned for Body and Spirit. Today's topic is neck pain. I'm Dick Nunez, Wellness Director of the Black Hills Health and Education Center. Welcome to Body and Spirit. Today's topic is neck pain. It's something I have a lot of experience with myself. I remember a while back in my younger days, I was doing a lot of heavy bench presses, and I hurt my back, and over the course of time, I didn't allow it to heal properly, and my right arm started to creep up, and before I knew it, I was having severe neck pain, and I lost 90% of the strength of my right arm overnight. Although I thought it was something to do lower in my back, the reality was it was in my neck. And it took me up to 10 years to rehabilitate my right arm. So I'm very aware of what it's like to have a bad neck and how complex a network of nerves and muscles are up there. But yet as I look at what the Bible teaches us about looking to do all things for the glory of God, and as I focus on my training and realize that I was too focused on myself as I tried to lift far beyond what my body was capable of. And then when I settled down and just started enjoying my training and learned what I was doing wrong and started to focus on taking care of my neck, the problem has drastically subsided and I really don't have those type of problems anymore. So what I'm going to try and do today is try and help you at home to understand what we can do if our neck starts to bother us. So I think we're ready to get started now. Helping me out today will be Mom Ford and Ethel. Thank you. Just go take it to the chair over there. Okay, ladies, you can go ahead and have a seat here. And we're going to start just by loosening up, and we're going to swing the arms around. Good. We're just going to get some circulation going there. And we're going to get ready to have some fun today. All right. Let's go the other way now. Good job. Okay, good, relax. I'm gonna come in between you here, and we're gonna have a little session here. We're gonna get in a prayerful position here. We're gonna need it. Okay, we're gonna push hard. Push with the palms of the hand. Okay, now we're gonna rotate our hands this way. And we're gonna push out. We're gonna pull back. And push out, and pull back. Whenever we deal with the neck area, we have to take the body as a whole and realize it all works together. The topic is neck pain, which is different than having a pain in the neck. Who knows what that might be caused by? Okay, just keep squeezing hard. Are you squeezing hard?
Yes.
Okay, are you?
Oh, yes.
All right. Just keep going. Do 10 more. Good. And 5 more. And last one. Good. Okay, I just want you to lean back in the chair and reach back. Reach back your arms. Good. There we go. Just reach back and hold it there. Okay. Go ahead and stretch it back. Go ahead and hit me if you want to. Okay, now give yourself a hug. Okay, we got that one down. Try and stretch back in here when you do that. Okay, go and reach back and bring it across. Okay, good. We're gonna do a little shoulder work now. We're gonna bring our hands up like this. And we're gonna push one arm up. And as it comes down, the other one's going up. Just like that, good. Right. Good. Okay, keep going. Try and get way up high. And you can take this at your own pace. If it's difficult for you, just go ahead and go slowly. Or if you want to add some resistance by putting some weights in your hand, we can do that as well. Ready for the weights yet? No? Not yet? Okay. Way up high. Reach way up there. Way up there. Okay, we're going to do five more on each side. You're looking like champs. Good. Okay, we can go ahead and stop. Okay, now what I want you to do is I want you to put your arms out to the side like this. We're going to come in to the middle and back out and back in and out. Good, keep going. It's very important to have good, strong shoulders whenever we want to have a good, strong, healthy neck. Keep it going. Okay, we're going to do five more. Good. Now just bring him back out. We're just going to hold it there. We're going to hold it there for 15 seconds. Okay? Keep holding on. Five. And 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15. Good. Okay, I want you to sit forward in your chairs. Now we're going to put the arms out like this. We're going to squeeze back like this, and we're going to feel the muscles in our upper back squeeze together. Okay, can you feel that back there? Can you feel it there? Tighten those muscles up, then reach back out. And pull. And reach back out. Good. Okay, you keep going. I'm going to come back here and just check and make sure we're getting a good feel here. You pull back. Good. Flex hard right in there. Hold it for just a moment longer. Okay, and then back out. Okay, pull back. Good. These are muscles that we don't spend a lot of time on. They're very important. Okay, pull way back. Hold it tight and reach out. Good. Again, pull and hold. Reach out. Good. Okay, keep going. I guess I can do two of you at the same time. I got two hands, right? Okay. Pull back, flex, and out. Good. Keep going. Okay, we're going to do about five more. And three more. Reach out, way out, one more time. And out, good. Okay, now we're gonna put one arm up over the head like this, and we're gonna stretch that area. Flexibility is a real key component, especially for neck pain, okay? Good. Okay, let's try and get an elbow a little bit better there. Okay. Okay, pull that way. Okay, relax, now let's grab the other side. Pull it across. Good. Okay, we're going to hold each stretch for about 10 to 15 seconds. Okay, good. Now what I want you to do is I want you to put one hand up by your ear, and I want you to push your head against your hand, and then back to the center. And push against your hand, and back up again. And push. Good. Let's keep it going. Your hand is doing the resistance for you as you tip your head from side to side. Okay. What we want to do here is we want to try and fatigue the neck muscles, because oftentimes neck pain is caused by simply having tension in the muscles. So if we do an exercise like this, oftentimes we can relieve that neck pain just because we're getting some range of motion in. Let's do five more. Feels kind of good, doesn't it? Okay, good. Let's switch the other side now. It's a real simple move to do. And you can determine how hard you want to work. Okay, go ahead and keep going. Just tip to the side there. Good. And back. Five more. And three more. Good, last one. Okay, now we're going to lean our head forward, and then we're going to look way back up at the ceiling. And lean forward and back up. Good. We're trying to flex the muscles as we go back. And just let the head come back down naturally. We're going to get real good at saying yes here. Way back and forward. Okay, and we're going to do 10 more. Feel the muscles contract in the neck each time you lay back. Does it feel good? Oh, okay, good. Three more times. Okay, now we're going to turn our head to the side. Look over to your side. Okay, let's look all the way around the other way. Turn and turn and turn and turn and turn. We'll do two more each way. Good. Last one. Good. Okay. Now what I want you to do is just put your arms out and reach them way back. And then back down. And we're just doing this for range of motion. Okay, keep going. Good. Now you can do this with dumbbells as well, or just with some cans of food, or even a couple books that are of similar size. Well, the stronger you get, the better you're gonna be. And the thing that's important to know that even if somebody's in their 70s, 80s, or 90s, they can still get a lot stronger. So just because you have a sore neck and you think, well, I'm 80 years old, what do I expect? Well, you can expect great things still if you do just get in there and do some regular exercise. Okay, let's do five more. Good, we're doing real good. And two more. Last one. Excellent. Okay. Now I want you to turn your palms up. And what we're gonna do here is we're gonna curl our arms up and reach down. Just like we have a big barbell in our hands. Or some dumbbells. Okay. Control your squeeze. You got some biceps there. We'll have to compare arms here. Good. Each time you come up, you want to think about flexing the arms, pressing them back down. Flex the arms as you curl up, then back down. Good. Okay, let's do 10 more. Again, you can dictate how hard you work here. You can use dumbbells or some type of added weights, but you can also just focus on flexing hard. Each time you flex hard, you're still going to get a feel there. Okay. Your weights are lighter than mine. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to bring our arms up over our head, and we're going to lower them down, and then we're going to push back up. Okay, we're going to be challenging ourselves a little bit to get all the way up. Now press all the way up. Good, bring it down. And all the way up high. Good. Okay, you don't need to lock behind your head. Just bring it down. Come down. There. Back up. Good. Okay, we want to keep those elbows in. Okay, bring it down. And way up high. There we go. That's better. Good. Try and feel it in those triceps. Again, we can use some weight on here if we want to, or I can add a little resistance here. Okay, push up, and down, and up. Good, up. A little harder now?
Yes.
Okay, up. Let's try and do five more of these. Again, you can just take a can of food if you want, have it in your hand. And two more. Good. Okay, just let the arms kind of shake out there. Get some blood circulating. You're not moving anymore? Okay, there we go. Okay, now what I want you to do is sit towards the edge of your chairs. And we're going to get a little bit further, way up there, okay? Now put one leg out straight. Okay, and you're going to raise that leg up and lower it back down. And up, keep the leg straight the whole time. And down, and up, and down. Good. This is a modified straight leg raise, doing it from seated position. What we want to show you here, though, is exercises for everybody, right? Not just for kids, not just for baby boomers, but everybody. I had Ethel and Mom Ford on for another program, and they loved it so much they wanted to come back and do some more. So here we are. Keep the leg straight. Okay, we're going to 10 more. And five more. Feeling that in your leg a little bit? You are? Good. How about you? Okay, that's X marks the spot. Okay, relax. Now do the other leg. Well, you're a go-getter. You're off and out of the starting blocks there. Remind me a little bit of that lady in that commercial where she's running down the street and doing pull-ups on the street lights. It's like Mom Ford. Okay, 10 more. And five more, good. Okay, now I want you to stand up. Okay, and get your feet apart. And cross your arms across your chest. And start slowly to sit yourself down to the chair. Sit down slowly. Sound slowly. Now back up again. And squat down slowly till you come to the chair. Good. And up. And down slowly. Good. And up. This is an excellent way of doing squats for seniors because it makes you control on the way down. Up. And then gives you a destination, which is the chair right beneath you. And up. We all need a destination in life, and yours is the chair. Okay, good. Up. Down slowly. Lower yourself with the muscles in your legs. Okay, down slow, real slow, slow. Feeling that on your knees a little bit? Okay, we're going to try and do five more. Lower yourself slowly. Good. And again, down slow. Good. And down slow. Down slow. One more time. Excellent. Okay, now what I want you to do is put one leg out and put your heel into the carpet. Your heel into the carpet, and I want you just to put a good pressure and pull back into the carpet so you feel it flex in that hamstring area. Feel that back there? Okay, bend your knee. Bend your knee there, Ethel. There, good. Now, and just drive your heel into the carpet real hard so you feel that contraction in the hamstring area. Okay, now start dragging your heel back into you. Okay, now reach out again and contract that hamstring and pull it back. Good, again. And we're gonna do it two more times. This is giving us a contraction of the hamstring and giving us a little bit of motion here with a little resistance of drag. Probably don't want to do this on the same part of the carpet all the time, or you might wear out the carpet. Okay, switch legs. Okay. Or if you have a hardwood floor, you can put some type of towel underneath your heel and drag that back as you do that. And two more. Last one. Good, good, good. Okay, now what I want you to do is I want you to cross a leg, okay, and uncross it, and cross the other leg, and down, and cross, okay, keep alternating it, good, okay, and what this is doing, other than looking a little bit like a Chinese fire drill, is working on the hips, good. Okay, let's try and do it in unison now. There we go. Good. All right, that's better. Nicely synchronized. Gonna get you ready for the Senior Olympics for synchronized swimming. Good. And we're gonna do five more on each side. She's got shorter legs than you. It makes it a little easier for her. Okay, good. Now put one leg out in front of you, and I want you to play windshield wiper with it. And this will work the internal and external rotation of the hip. If it feels a little awkward at first, that's okay. Just keep working with it. It'll get better. Okay, we're going to do 10 more each way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I think it's time to change the wiper blade on your side here. Okay, okay, let's go. Good. Again, this is working internal and external rotation of the hip, which is very, very beneficial for seniors who want to keep those hip sockets nice and healthy and well lubricated with lots of fresh oxygenated blood, right? Okay, 10 more. Okay, keep going. 7, 8, 9, 10, good. Okay, now I want you to just pull one knee up towards your chest. Pull it up there. All right. Nice steady pull. You should feel it in the back of your leg there a little bit. Okay, now switch. Okay, good. Okay, now sit on the edge of the chair again. Put your feet in behind you further. Okay, push up onto your toes. And back down, and up and down. Good, let's do 20 of those. A little slower. Good, all right, that's better. The reason why we scooted forward a little bit, that gives us a little better range of motion on the way down. You know, a lot of times when people get hurt, and they stumble, especially when they get older, is they don't pick their foot up properly, and their toe catches on something, and down they go. try and fix that here. Okay, that's good. Now put your leg, sit back in your chair, put your legs out in front of you again. Now I want you to point your toes back at yourself. Now point it out away from you. Good, and let's do that now. Now this is working the anterior tibialis. That's some muscles on the front of the shins here. And again, this will help for when we pick up the foot, that we have more strength on lifting that toe up, and it helps us to make sure we don't trip on something. Well, I trip a lot anyway. I wonder what my excuse is. Okay, seven more. Good. All right, good. Now sit towards the edge of the chair again. Now I want you to turn like this. Okay, just turn your trunk. Okay, now turn the other way. Good. And turn. And turn. And turn. And turn. Good. We're going to do three more each way. Okay, and back. Good. Okay, we're all done. As you can see, no matter what age you are, we can still get into a good exercise program, and we can keep those necks nice and healthy all through our senior years. So many neck problems are caused simply because of the fact that we don't keep good balance of the muscles in our neck area, or we've let our posture go and our head's tipping forward. Whenever we have that forward head tilt, we're going to set ourselves up for problems. People can go in and get chiropractic adjustments, they can take medication, but unless they change what's causing the problem, the pain's just going to keep going, and they're going to be caught in a vicious cycle. So if we get in a regular exercise program that's designed to train the entire back area and keep the neck really flexible, we can expect to go through our senior years and still have no pain in the neck. So remember, whenever we exercise, we want to do it for the right reason. We can beat our heads against the wall and get nothing out of it, or we can focus on Christ and know that we're doing it for the right reason. And remember, the Bible says, do all things through Christ, because He's the one that truly strengthens us. God bless you. We'll see you next time.